Hi guys, this is Abiyuddin Ahmad Siddiqui. Now we are moving towards arrays. So before we put array into a practical, so we need to understand the basic theory concepts of array. Now basically array is a container. It's a container object that holds a fixed number of values of single type. The length of an array is established when the array is created. Its length is fixed, that means 0 till the last element or subscript. It includes subscript, element, upper bound and lower bound. It consists of three types, simple or one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional. Now here we have a block of array having 10 elements and is demonstrated as under. You can see that this is a lower bound area, that means where you are starting with the zero value. Zero is the first index and the last index is the ninth. You can see this H is stored over here, and this is known as upper bound, which is the highest value, or this is also known as indices, the block. This is the indices of this. So the letter H or element H stored at index 9. Here you can see it is stored at index 9. Now array length is 10, subscript is 10, that means 10 array element of 10 array element. Then the talk will be about this. Subscript is about around 10, and around 10 means 0 to 9 equals to 10. Array 1, 10, which means 0 to 9 elements at most. Always remember that array length must be less than the subscript at this stage. If you exceed or put by mistake equals to operator to just read the values from array, there will be an array index out of bound error will generate. So to avoid that thing, always remember that array always start with the value 0, and you have to remember that if you are omitting 0, then you have to fix the subscript or total number of element accordingly. Array size, the values which you are iterating from the array must be lesser than the array size. It must be lesser than upper bound. That means if you are going to store 10 values, that means 0 to 9 is 10. Okay, so that means the 10th, 1, 0 is the value which you will limit the array length. So that it will always be lesser than the array limit. Keep watching. Now how to declare array? We are declaring a variable for an arrays. Now here you can understand how to declare array variables. It can be declared for byte array symbol, array bytes, short, array shorts, long, array longs. I have just put S additional so that the name will not correspond to the default names. With the default names, float, array floats, doubled, array doubles, boolean, array boolean, character, array character, strings and array strings. Now after declaring array, we need to have a subscript assigned for each type. That means byte array bytes equals to new byte 10. That means the size of byte, that means which hold 10 bytes. That means 10 different sizes or 10 containers, 10 places for storing 10 bytes or 10 elements at byte variable. Size is 10 elements can be stored. Short, array shorts equals to new short 5. Casting is the main type of data type is short. 5, size is 5 elements can be stored. Same as here with the long, array longs, this is the array name. This is the long new object type from long. This is a 5 size here. And floats, array float names, new float. Float is a type of data. And then you have initialized with the 10. Then double, same as here, 7 types. And then you have boolean, array booleans, new boolean 8, yes, no, true, false, 1, 0 and on and off. Characters, array characters, new character, character is a data type which is returning the value to this array name given. They are having 10 values, and then string, array strings, new strings, 12 strings. Now initializing an array will be the something different. For example, you are storing some value at point 0 or at index 0. Because this is numeric value, that is why there is nothing to enclose within quote. So array long 0 equals to 100, that means initialize with array. Then here you have some array strings 0. Welcome to the system. This is a string type array string. So that is why this is enclosed within double quote. Then array characters, why it could be used for yes or no. Right? So this is something regarding how to initialize arrays. Now accessing arrays. How to access? For example, you have stored data in arrays and then this is the time you want to display it onto the screen. System.out.println element 1 at index 0 if you want to discuss the position of the element being stored. 0 array 0 you have set here. Then element 2 index 1 element 1. Then system element 3 at index 2. So 0, 1, 2, that means there are 3 elements stored and being displayed on screen with the help of system.out.println function. So this is outputting the stored values from array 1, 0 element, array 1, 1 element and array 1, 2nd element. In this way, you have stored 3 different elements at same location. This is the same location, array 1, array 1, array 1. Having 0 index, having 1 index, having 2 index. Now, note if you go to this thing in the array access, it has accessed array 0, array 1 and array 2 respectively or irrespective of what data you stored in it using same name with different element stored on it. For instance, array 0 may have identification, array 1 may have name and array 2 may have cell number and so on. So this is where you understood the concepts of array. So in the next sessions you will come to know about 1D array, 2D array and 3D array. Thanks for watching.